How's it going, guys, and welcome back to the channel. You know what? If you own a snowmobile, then there's probably only one thing you like more than snowmobiles, and that's snowmobile gear. And that's what we're going to talk about in today's video. I'm going to show you a new piece of gear that I just got my hands on and give you my thoughts. So stick around. For me, for a piece of gear that I carry on my sled, it's got to meet a couple of criteria. It's got to be small enough that I can carry it easily in a backpack or in my saddlebags. It's got to be lightweight, and it's got to be useful, right? So, and that's just because you have a limited amount of space. Now, I think the Stuckmate actually fits those criteria, so it does fit quite easily in my saddlebags with everything else. It is super lightweight. So I did do a previous video on getting your snowmobile unstuck, and the whole reason I did that is that I found it a little unnerving the first couple of times I got stuck. You know, after you ride for a while, it just becomes normal. It's something that happens and you figure out how to get out. And I did have a lot of good comments on things that people do to get their snowmobile unstuck. Now, some guys will just say, you know what, I just get off the sled, I pick the back end up, I move it, and off I go. And sometimes that works. Other times you really get these things stuck. It depends on where you are, the angle they're on. But the thing to remember is that, you know, the new machines, for starters, are much lighter than an older machine like this one. Believe me, this is built like a tank. And secondly, not all riders are created equal. So some guys can just get off a sled, pick it up, manhandle it, no problem. I'm not a huge guy. You know, there's different techniques and different situations, and they're not all the same. Now, one of the techniques that I talked about in my previous video and that you hear from time to time is to have a second person to help you to pull on the ski while you give it a little bit of throttle. Now, you hear mixed comments about whether or not that's safe. And you know what? Fundamentally, I would have to say this is a motorized machine and you're in front of it when you're pulling. So it's something that, you know, let's say you really want to be careful doing it. You want to position yourself off to the side of the machine. You really want to be aware of where that machine is going to go when it starts to move. But that said, if it's the difference between the risk of, you know, possibly getting injured by pulling on this snowmobile and being stuck out in the cold, which can be really disastrous, then, you know, this technique is something that you want to consider. Okay, so that's the situation where the Stuckmate kind of comes to mind, right? If I'm alone and I can't get my snowmobile unstuck and I want to pull on the ski, but I can't reach the throttle at the same time, obviously. But it's not really only for that scenario that this thing is designed. You know, if you have two riders and you have the Stuckmate, then you can work the throttle and both of you can pull on the skis. So, you know, let me just take this thing out and I'll show you how it works. All right, so it comes in its own little carrying pouch. We've got the Stuckmate itself, and we've got a nice plasticized set of instructions. Now, obviously, I had a few concerns when I first saw this product, and I think some of you would as well, right? Because you are connecting something to the throttle, and you know, you're probably gonna be in front of the snowmobile or in front and to the side. So that said, I still think there's opportunities where this product would be useful, but you have to be really careful with it. So the first thing I would say is, you know, make sure that you start with the sled shut off, right? You don't want to be playing around with the throttle while it's running. That's kind of a given. Now the other thing, I've said this before when I've done videos about starting a snowmobile, is you want to work the throttle and you want to make sure it's not sticking. Well, the same thing with this thing, I'm going to want to work it and make sure that it's not sticking. So you want to make sure the cable is running over the handlebar. And then we're gonna go ahead and put this on the throttle. Okay, so that's basically what it looks like on the sled, and that's what it does. Now, the one thing that crossed my mind, and I'm sure it's crossed yours, is, you know, the notion of the sled taking off on its own because this thing is stuck and depressing the throttle. Now, in the instructions, there's actually a lanyard here to put around your wrist, and then, so now I've got an image of the sled taking off down the trail with me dragging along behind it. But the one thing that kind of made me feel a lot better about this product is this feature. So if I take this and I just yank on it, it actually comes right off, and it comes off really easily. Like, I didn't have to try that too hard. And I can actually try this from a few different angles. It pulls off super easy. All right, guys, so there's the Stuckmate. So that's what it's for, and that's how you use it. You know, I'm not doing a how-to video here. There's documentation on the Stuckmate website. I'm just kind of giving you my thoughts on it and showing you what it's all about. I don't get paid. I'm not sponsored to do any of this. I just sort of share my thoughts on products that I happen to get. So my final thoughts. I actually can remember an occasion where I had the sled stuck, and I was actually quite close to some trees, and it wasn't very convenient for me to push it or pull it. And I do remember at one point thinking, God, I wish I could reach the throttle from where I was. And this sort of lets me do that. It is something that I would want to have in my saddlebag. So there you go. And if you have used the Stuckmate, or if you've got an opinion or a question about it, go ahead and post in the comments below. I'd love to hear from you guys. You can also reach out to me on Facebook. I'll put the link in the description below. Or you can follow me on Twitter, @myownsled. All right, guys, I hope you liked that video. Until next time, I'm Dave Clark, and thanks for watching.